Who's for which all?
I'm Peavine.
Peavine? Okay, thank you. So Argenta is not actually sending out J-Dog first. It will be sending out another player. Argenta sending out a Cloud first. And Peavine sends out Mega. Will be either way, we have a Cloud versus Toon Link starting off. Oh, the Cloud gets a nice read on the air dodge. Giving himself a forward smash. Jab combo, but falling dare is gonna take some percent. Ooh, goes deep for the climb hazard, doesn't get it. Toon Link rolls to the ledge, wanting to try to maybe get some cheese back throws going. But unfortunately cannot seal the deal. And another downer from the Cloud. He's gonna send the Toon Link off stage. He's gonna try to get a landing. Hits the tip of the up smash. We have some hype for another singles match going on. And a fully charged forward smash. Mega's looking like he's having some trouble here. A lot of going on. Mega trying to build a little momentum for himself. Cloud does have that limit though. Makes him a lot faster on the ground and in the air. He's getting some nice frame traps with the boomerang and the projectiles, but he's not capitalizing off of them. He does not accidentally suicide on Smashville. Gets a dash attack. If he had gone for an up smash, he might have been able to get the kill. Oh, but he gets spiked from the forward air. Manages to avoid the up air. And he still doesn't get an up smash as a punish. Only the dash attack, which isn't going to kill. But he does manage to finally secure the stock. 11-11. Oh, he's really high. He hits the down air to land again. Cross slashes, though. And gets some percent on. He catches his own bomb. Manages to get rid of it before it can explode. And Cloud wishes a dash attack. Another dash attack. Good DI. Keeps him alive off the top. Toon Link with a lot of rage. Nearly at max rage. Ooh, some jabs. Oh, and baits him into the cross slash. I think I am backwards on my halls here. So Dylan is coming up.
You're Peavine Hall, right?
Yeah.
Okay, making.
I had it backwards, my bad. So Argenta actually is going up a stock. No, I was right. I was right the first time. Dylanator's gonna end up stepping it up. He's gonna go DDD again though, and he will.
But I'm back, sir, baby.
Good Sir Slugma, how did it go for you, man? Did you win?
Not well at all.
Oh.
I was playing against one of my roommates, so I decided to do a friendly set of randos. And I lost the randos.
Dang. So Dylan's going to take 11% deficit. He doesn't care about starting at that. Just wanted to make sure the stock count is correct. And Rhett is going to eat a forward smash. Dylan just needs to get one stock to even things back up. He goes for another forward smash. He's looking to just end this quick. Or he's just wanting to get another good highlight. Like last time he was up.
No.
Goes for an up smash instead of a forward smash. Much better in terms of coverage. Much less hype. Ooh, up smash is going to end up clipping DDD's back air as he then sneaks under it.
Oh.
Oh, the Gordo! Oh my word, that almost ended his life. Oh, and he just blows the finishing touch, forgetting that DDD has multiple jumps. DDD lands. Can he get a punish? He does with the dash attack. Rat's trying to go for some up throws. Oh, but he doesn't get anything. Oh, down smash is going to take it.
Take it.
And Dylan ends up evening it up for Peavine Hall. We are at 10 stocks apiece. And who is going to come up for Argenta?
Part of me feels like it was a risky move sending Dylan in early.
I believe so.
Just due to the fact that if he loses a stock, he's now going to have twice as hard of a time trying to beat J-Dog.
That is true. I think some of their members of the Hall might have left, so I'm not 100% sure exactly what is up with that. I'm sure we'll be seeing here soon enough. But Argenta is going to be sending in a Korin player here named Endgame, who is seen a little bit around the Smash community itself. I have not played him or know much about him, so unfortunately I can't really give a whole lot of info. He plays Korin.
I played him earlier today. He beat me. I'm not the best player in Smash though, however. I enjoy the game. More of a hobby at this point, but based on what he did to me, he's decent, if not good.
We'll have to see if he can try to pull a lead here. We are again dead even between Peavine and Argenta in the semifinals of the Hall Crew Battles, and he leads off with a claw to Reflector Gordo. Dylan gets a down tilt punish, tries to go for a back air edgeguard, but doesn't get it. Spaces it though, so he can't get shield grabbed. Ooh, another Reflector to Gordo.
Oh,
ooh, gets the counter, but it's not enough to kill yet. Reflects the Gordo with an up smash, doing very well. Dylan's not seeming to mind him being near this edge right now. Ooh, and he gets impaled. Endgame trying to go for the up B earlier. Seems like he was just trying to tack on extra percent. It can kill, but I wouldn't say it can kill DDD at this early. Uses an up throw, which is a kill throw, but not anywhere near this percentage. Oh, if he had held it any longer, that might have killed. Still have the right idea. Reflects the Gordo with that side B. It's not up. Oh, hits him with the projectile, and that ends up taking the stock.
That is just... that is utterly...
oh, but Dylan returns it immediately! Gets a read with the forward smash, what he's been looking for the entire time, and finally hits it. Returns it. Endgame missing a follow-up after his projectile, though. Dylan just needs to safely recovery. Gets up, punches with a forward tilt. Gordo. Counters. Dylan's using his multiple jumps to avoid the projectile. Oh, but he gets tagged finally. And just drops the Gordo. Rolls into the forward smash, but it was not the tipper, or else it would have been a very bad day for him. Endgame throws out a counter. Definitely showing stage control right now. counters the Gordo again for seemingly no reason. Oh, Dylan hits a down smash. Gordo set up. Throws it a little early, so he can't get a really full setup off of it. Safely throws out a forward tilt. Blocks the lunge, but doesn't get a punish. It is punishable, but if you cross up with it, it makes it a lot more difficult. Endgame properly waits for the get-up attack. Very good patience by him. Flecking the Gordo again, not letting Dylan work with anything. Oh, neutral air, but he tries to go for a down tilt. Down smash! Bad angle. Oh, that does not hit the edge. Oh, wow. And you even got a power shield sound? What? Oh, he hits the Gordo, but it's not going to be enough. Oh, reflection again.
The Gordo.
Dylan gets the shield. Oh, jab! And it's going to come off the top!
Jab kill.
That is not necessarily uncommon. Jab for a DDD can be a good bit, a little bit of a kill move. I mean, he was sitting at 127%. Is a fair amount of rage. I think Dylan could have read my lips there. And J-Dog isn't back going to come up against Dylanator. Will he be able to style on Dylan is the question of the night.
I don't know. We'll have to see if he actually plays Ganon right now, though.
I doubt that he wouldn't. So the players actually can't see what's going on right now because apparently, I guess the monitor somehow got turned off. However, as you can see, they're trying to look at the screen, and they're back on the TV.
Cool.
Don't forget to suicide, Dylan.
I know.
Okay.
I'm not like everybody else.
Cool. Shots out. Shots fired to Tolerable Zero there. And everyone else.
And a lot of other people. He does. He does because you're ahead. He does because you just beat the last guy, so he gets counterpick. So Dylan claiming it's easy. Getting neutral. So we'll see what ends up happening. J-Dog starting off strong with a double fair string. Some more jabs by DDD holding off well. Ooh, up airs the PK fire. Dylan trying to just get himself out of the corner right now. Seeming to have a little bit of struggles. Gets a down tilt. Ooh, looks for the forward smash but doesn't get it. Goes for another down tilt. Doesn't get anything. Gordo was not quite fast enough to punish. A little bit of some whiffs on Dylan's part, but he's not hot yet. Oh, if that had hit, that might have broken his shield. Tries to go for a down smash, but that's not going to be a punish. PK flash to hold Dylan at bay. J-Dog's definitely looking like he's in control. A back air is going to do it. And Argenta Hall is back tight again. No more than a one-stock different in either of these games. So.
We have a crowd favorite here, Alex.
Alex here is a crowd favorite. However, he is going against J-Dog, who is not playing Ganon. So style levels could be...
Style and Ness.
So people are getting confused. Yes, so Peavine is confirmed to have only four players, so they are allowed to rotate in two people. But every single person has to go once before that.
Yes.
Is the official ruling.
Alex, you got this. You go, Alex! Yeah, Alex!
Can you
feel the electricity in the air.
I feel bad for his soul.
Nest
nears. Nest dittos.
So J-Dog is going to be running the parentheses X parentheses tag, so then you guys can tell the difference between the two Nesses. But this should be a very interesting matchup. Nest dittos are weird, I would imagine. So neither has to suicide. Alex starting off with a good percentage until he gets hit by a down throw fair combo. Whiff grabs left and right. Oh my word, that was like four in a row. J-Dog tries to go for the absorption of PK Fire, but was just off space. Yeah, so J-Dog is black.
Oh, the backlash!
Hits another one. Hits a forward throw. Oh, puts him onto the platform. Awkward situation, but no capitalization or loss of stock for no reason. Oh, PK Thunder 2! Oh, if he was any further away from that edge, he would have committed suicide in that risky maneuver. J-Dog looks like he still wants to try to do some sort of styling here. But can he do it? No follow-up, unfortunately. Tries to go for the back air, but misses. Gets two PK Thunders. Almost went into a PK Thunder 2. Misses his up air. Oh, no. I use the back throw early, but at least forced him off stage.
Oh!
Attempts the PK Flash. But J-Dog smart enough to air dodge it, but a back throw! Peavine going down a stock.
But J-Dog's trying to work on his momentum, keeping it up.
And they're starting to cheer. Peavine trying to get that behind their boy right now.
Where's the USA chance? I really miss those.
We're not having a country fight here.
I know.
That's something I know of. Oh, PK Thunder 2 connects, but it's not going to high enough percent in order to kill. Oh my god, right into the PK Flash, but a very small PK Flash into the tail of the regular PK Thunder. J-Dog has evened up the percent, but he's still up a stock. Tries to bait out something with the PK Flash again. Oh no.
Oh! Looking like he's in the mafia with that bat to the face.
That was absolutely disgusting.
That was very gross. I was honestly expecting the attempt at a spike. Just a quick short hop spike, but
he's still feeling the style. He's still feeling the style.
He wants to.
And now, Dank memes.
Now, Dank is up. This matchup, I think, is better for Game & Watch than it is a Nesmir. Dank ended up playing Nate, or NTG, a little earlier in the match. Things, he got 2-0'd, but it was by no means a very like hard 2-0. It wasn't a stomp by any regards in either game. But we'll see if Taylor is his name here, or Dank, can get some momentum back for Peavine here. They are down by two stocks, so they've got a little bit of work to go. But you can bet that they'd be sending in Dillinator again, and Dillin will probably even end up going Sonic. But J-Dog for right now is up a good 31%.
Oh, and he gets hit by the PK Thunder 2 and Game & Watch!
Oh my god!
Game & Watch being so light that PK Thunder 2 killed him at 50 across the stage. I am not sure if there was a mix of bad DI in there, but that was still rough for Peavine regardless.
I don't know what to think about that.
Oh no.
Oh.
However, if Game & Watch can get the Ness off stage, he can bucket the PK Thunder to stop Ness's recovery. So he can definitely try to turn this around if he can get a good Gimp. Getting the bacon. Oh, if that was a down smash, that would have worked. Down throw. Up smash. Oh, he was.
Nice.
gets the punish. Has him off stage, but... Now, if he can hit a 9, if he can get a gimp, he can definitely bring this back only to either a 1-stock deficit. Oh, 8! Goes for the fully charged up smash, but doesn't get it. An up smash of his own by J-Dog. Will we see him go for another hammer, but a back throw! We like to call that back throw, boys.
And this is why I really do stress some new players to sometimes play Ness, because if you can get that back throw combo, it's beautiful.
Yeah, it works out well. It's very easy. So Peavine is technically out of players, so they again are able to rotate in two, and Dylan is salty, going for the run back.
The salty.
I know you won't. He looked me in the eyes and told he's not going to go DDD, and I know that he won't. It's either Sonic or there's something else he's working on that I'm going to slap him for later.
Oh, Mega Man.
Okay, I would have gotten up from the seat and I would have gotten up and slapped you. Yes, you do. So he takes him to Duck Hunt. The very long stage gives Sonic a lot of room to run, and a lot of time to run.
Oh.
Wow, and just calling him out with that bat right off the bat. Just being like, I know you're gonna run at me, I'm gonna force the shield. But Dylan's sitting up at 37% right now. Gets a down throw. Yeah, Dylan racking up a lot of percent right now. He's sitting on a nice lead, and he only has to get 1 stock right now. The more you can get, the better, right? The better, though. Trying to bait out a lot of moves from J-Dog with Sonic's fast speed. Oh, almost called him out with the forward smash. Almost got the tech punish. J-Dog trying to play very carefully. There's a fair amount of rage right now with being at high percent. So back throw might be able to kill it like anywhere from 20 to 40% more, depending upon where he ends up on the stage. Dylan just doing some mind games right now to try to see if he can bait anything. PK Thunder 2!
Oh!
Back throw is not going to do it yet for Sonic, but a little bit more and he might be able to. Goes for a low edge guard read. Doesn't get it. Oh, misses an up smash. Can't forward smash either. Already back up to 55%. Oh, misses the forward tilt. Dylan just trying to bait things out yet again. Oh, he was looking for another PK Thunder 2, but it wasn't going to happen. He goes for it again. Up throw. J-Dog's playing very well right now. Ooh, good back air. Good air dodge. But Ness is at maximum rage. If he gets a back throw at any point, Dylan gets a back throw of his own. Not enough. Dylan goes for the same angle again. This is a very scary situation for either player.
Oh!
The duck! The duck!
The duck.
All He tries to PK Thunder to a read or the homing attack. And he PK Thunders into the duck. And because the duck isn't there, it can't block the homing attack. And the homing attack kills him.
Oh.
What is this game?
I don't know anymore. I have seen too many beautiful things today to understand.
So, Peavine is sitting in a very difficult situation, though. They have Dillinator's got one stock. They have another player with two stocks. And they have to go through three full people. So we will see
if Peavine can make the run back or not.
Zero suit.
It's Wolf again, who played... Or no, I think he's just using the Wolf tag. I don't think it's the same player.
So.
They're different
Wolf
player.
Running pit
pits.
Yeah.
The, both pits. No, he picks. He picks because he comes in. I forgot to change characters from the last match, but... So Dillon does have to lose the one stock. Dillon's going to be trying to use some
dash dancing.
He's trying to use his sonic speed in order to try to bait moves out of his opponent. The question is his opponent, will his opponent fall for them? Will he overcommit to something? So he whiffs a grab, but Dillon whiffs a punish. Forward air, up air. Attacks on a little percent. The Zero Suit holding himself very well though right now. Staying only slightly behind. Ooh, gets hit. Springs up. Dillon hits an up air. Ooh, almost seemed like he was trying to bait for something. Rhythm, I don't know if John left yet or not. I don't see him right now, but there's a crowd of people behind blocking my view. And a back throw.
Chill.
Dillon needs to take one more stock, though, and then another stock after that in order to try to close things out.
Dude, no way.
That's beautiful. Ooh, up B! Can't get anything off the boost kick, though. Doesn't connect. Hits a forward smash, though, racking up the percentage on Dillon. Dillon almost rolls into the side beam. Get some forward tilt clashes. Dillon goes for the up air. Any more rage, and that might have killed. But he's only at 85, so he doesn't have a whole lot of it yet. He has some. But he's definitely working on this comeback right now. Hits the up smash. Zero Suit knows how to air dodge. Oh! DBZ! Neither player dies, though. Wow, the homing attack and the boost kick clash.
Got it. Oh, and the up smash for the kill.
And Dillon has got one stock remaining and manages to bring it back 3-4. If he manages to take two stocks, he takes the lead for Peavine Hall.
It'll be interesting to see.
Can he do it?
The way his Sonic's playing right now? I think he could.
I think if he keeps the mentality up, I think he can do it. Because he's still got to go... Yeah, he needs two more. He can either be down one, be down two, or go up. Is where the scenario is at. And it's going to be
Gizmo
stepping up for Argenta.
Oh.
Now, I did get to play Gizmo a little bit. He's fairly decent. I think he has an idea of what he's doing with the game.
And he's playing that DDD.
I have no idea what to think about this matchup.
I have no clue either.
I feel like it should be bad for DDD, but if he gets a couple of clean hits... So we'll be going to Final
Talos
Destination.
Omega.
What's up, Chair? All right. So Dylan's starting off trying to rack some percent. Very early. Gets a nice down throw. Can he get a tech? I think he had spot dodged when he meant to go for another down throw. Forward air strings, though. And Dylan's showing that this matchup is very awkward for DDD. So he's just kind of running around the big guy. Almost a huge whiff for him there. Oh, a very good forward tilt. He gets a grab. Gizmo just needs to take one stock to keep his all in the lead. Oh, the inhale! Dylan not falling for the up smash, but he also plays the character. So we should know a little bit about some DDD shenanigans. Ooh, I thought he was going to go too soon. Up B, right into the forward air. Oh my word! Ooh, reflects the Gordo with the spin dash and hits the spin dash. Another Gordo coming in. Oh, big punish. Can he get an up air? Gets the air dodge bait, but he was too low in order to punish it. Not quite yet, but DDD's max rage. Ooh, forward air right into forward tilt. Oh, DDD gets hit by the spring. But he's fine. Dylan can't get a punish on the up B landing. DDD sitting at 172%. A lot of rolling around. There's definitely some mirrors on the table. Down throw. Dylan's gonna up B, and he gets hit by the down smash, though. Dylanator is out, and Peavine is down to their last person, who needs to take out four full stocks. I'm not going to lie when I'm saying that I'm a little bit doubtful, but who knows? Who knows?
I don't blame you for being doubtful right now.
I mean, it's a dire situation, to say the least, but we've see it all. I've seen it all throughout years playing this game.
I've seen many things, so. I can always hope for the underdog story.
Remember, the winner plays Canada Hall in the finals.
Yes.
And they are sending out Mr. Dank.
Mr. Dank.
To try for the comeback.
Either way, we're going to have a good final set with Candle Hall having a very good team along with everybody else. With both Peavine and Argenta having a solid team as well. So.
I agree. I think maybe Dylan going in earlier in the second rotation was probably a little bit greedy. I think he just wanted the run back, but... But J-Dog is definitely MVP of Argenta Hall today.
Carrying the entire team to a 12-0 victory.
Earlier, and then he still took, I think, at least four or five stocks. Earlier?
Ooh.
Man, why can't RT
little bit.
Right? Oh, I thought he was going to go for try to 9. Ooh, gets swallowed. Air dodges through the Gordo. Oh!
Right into the forward smash.
Forward smash from Gizmo ends up ending his stock. Peavine is on their last stock. Ooh, hits an up smash. One stock to 3. Ooh, good up tilt by Gizmo, but misses the up smash follow-up. Good set of jabs, pushes DDD off stage. Ooh, good read on the roll. But a good grab by Gizmo. Gets a lot of percentage. Ooh, very good trap, but can't get another Gordo out since he had one out already. And another forward smash!
It will go to Argenta
with 3 stocks.
I started the bets 1 game.
It will go to Argenta versus Canada. And they're sending out tolerable 0 right away.
Right away. Wow, they're just going right into this. And Gizmo is not getting off his seat.
This isn't Cruz.
Oh, is this in Cruz? Is this? Are we back to singles?
Okay.
Never mind then.
We're going back to singles.